Come fill up your glasses and gather all around. Tell you the truth, what's a going on down? All through the country, people sounding the alarm. Everybody wondering what's a happening on the farm. Now the businessman says, let the strongest one survive. But if he ain't got food, how they gonna stay alive? Politician says, everything's a getting better. But you might as well be standing behind a compost spreader. Ask any farmer in Kansas. Ask any farmer in Carolina too. Out in Dakota, Kentucky, Minnesota. And I guarantee you'll find what I'm saying is true. Well, I believe it all started about a dozen years ago. Everybody scratched to make a little dough. The banker saw the land prices go high. Went to the farmer, said bye, bye, bye. Now don't you need a little money? Don't you need a little loan? Don't you need some new machinery? A mortgage on your home? Then the land price fell till everything's a debit. And the banker comes back, says now you ain't got the credit. And I'd really like to help you, but it's out of my control. Now the farmer's in hock, but the banker's on a roll. Ask any farmer in Kansas. Ask any farmer in Carolina too. Out in Dakota, Kentucky, Minnesota, and I guarantee you'll find what I'm saying is true. Now, fruit time, I'm telling you, trouble on the farm ain't nothing new. You got the fever of a government, the flooding on the ground. Hard times, something every farmer knows about. The costs go up, the prices stay down, so you don't get nothing when you bring it into town. Nobody's worried, yet you got to understand. Now I'm about to tell you, and it really is a famine. When the farmer can't pay for the low, low prices, and the banker's in trouble, then you got a crisis. Uncle Sam steps in, till the banker's in clover. The newspapers tell us that the crisis is over, and they call it a solution, but the facts all mocker, cause the money all stays in the pinstripe pocket. Ask any farmer in Kansas. Ask any farmer in Carolina too. Out in Dakota, Kentucky, Minnesota, and I guarantee you find out what I'm saying is true. Then we sat down the farmer and we told him what to do. We said feed the world and keep the price cheap too. So the devil of production kept the prices way down by loading up on chemicals and spreading them around. Now you got cheap food and you know there's plenty of it. Don't taste like nothing but your checkbook's flooded and the topsoil washes, the land goes dry. The farmers get sick and the earthworms die. Ask any farmer in Kansas. Ask any farmer in Carolina. Out in Dakota, Kentucky, Minnesota, and I guarantee you'll find out what I'm saying is true. It's mighty hard to figure, no, I'll never understand. We got so much food and there's hunger in the land. You might get a little bite of that surplus cheese, but most of that food gets shipped overseas, where it's so, so cheap. The farmers over there go belly up, but hell, we don't care, because the plan is for the food of all them nations be raised right here by big corporations. Ask any farmer in Kansas. Ask any farmer in Carolina too. Out in Dakota, Kentucky, Minnesota, and I guarantee you'll find out what I'm saying is true. They say you better get bigger or you better get out. The only way to get bigger is for another get out. They pit the farmers in this world against each other, when really we ought to be sisters and brothers, and we're never gonna make it until we realize we gotta stick together. We got to organize, stop killing our farmers, giving our land, handing all the profits to the middleman. It's like all this time we've been going to the tail saying, charge it.